It was a long time coming. Months of stress and fears vanished after a Shelbyville pastor detained overseas was finally allowed to come home. We first showed you the reunion last night. News Channel 5's Matthew Torres checked in with the pastor to see how he's settling in.
From the reunion at the airport to the parade outside of his home the next morning, Pastor Brian Nairn's welcome gift has been exhilarating and relieving.
We did a whole lot of crying this morning, because this morning it was very real that it's finally over. I'm finally back at home.
For more than 7 months, the Shelbyville pastor had been stuck in India after his passport was taken away. But today he's waking up in his own bed with his family by his side.
I walked around in the yard and looked at grass. I haven't seen any grass in 7.5 months.
It's a stark difference to his months quietly staying at a motel. Nairn was first sent to jail in India for the money he was carrying for missionary work. He was accused of entering without proper documents for the money. Money his attorneys say he declared and wasn't even enough to be considered a crime. They claim he was jailed after being asked if he was a Christian.
And they just refused to release me.
Pastor Nairn wasn't even sure if he'll make it back to Nashville. He says he was released 5 times in India, but each time officials changed their mind.
5 separate times we went to court with an agreement, everything done, only to show up at court and be told, no, we're not going to do it.
But after multiple attempts, his charges were finally dropped and travel ban lifted on Friday with the help of the U.S. ambassador to India. Nairn plans on never visiting the country again, even though he's been there over the years. He says he's not letting what a few people did waver his faith or love for the people.
They all have the same core value. They want to love their family, take care of their family, and work and be left alone.
Matthew Torres, News Channel 5.
Pastor Nairn plans to preach for the first time in more than 7 months this Sunday at International House of Prayer Ministries in Shelbyville.